We're now going to show you how to test the aerodynamic properties of your car. To do this, you need to open up Autodesk Flow Design. First, select Import from your local drive, and then select the STL file of your assembled car on the drive. When your car appears in Flow Design, select the wind tunnel settings on your toolbar. The moving particles you'll then see indicate the direction of the wind through the tunnel. Using these settings, you can adjust the size of the wind tunnel with the on-screen manipulators. In the dialog box which appears, there's an option to adjust the tunnel's wind speed to reflect the velocity of the car when it's traveling along the track. If your car is facing in the wrong direction or upside down, you can use the orientation tool to point it in the right direction or put it the correct way up. Using the toolbar, you can display your car in a two-dimensional or a three-dimensional wind tunnel. For the purpose of our aerodynamic tests, we're going to use the 3D format. Click next on Drag Plot on your toolbar. This brings up a display of data such as the car's average drag coefficient. That's a measure of how much resistance your car puts up when it's traveling through the air. When the two lines meet on the chart you'll plot for your drag coefficient, it indicates how efficiently the car cuts through the air. The lower the coefficient number, the more aerodynamic the car is. In order to see how the wind tunnel air travels over the car and to see the areas of the car creating the most resistance, you need to select flow lines on your toolbar. You can choose to see the air flowing in different ways as lines, tubes, smoke or particles, whichever you prefer. In the flow line settings box, you can adjust the settings until they match the conditions for a real wind tunnel. The flow lines around your car will vary according to the data you put in for such things as size, length, and speed. If you select surface pressures on your toolbar, you'll be able to see which areas of your car are creating the most drag or air resistance. This will help you decide whether to modify the design. Once you've input all the data relevant to your car, click on Drag Coefficient to get a figure for the aerodynamic efficiency of your design. You can compare this with any future designs you test to see whether you've improved the properties of the car.